comfortable. And your foot's on my back. sweating. Feels good outside, but I just sweat to sweat. So it has warmed up. So for work, one of the vendors we used added a permission and didn't notify anyone of their customers that you have to enable the permission. Thankfully, there is a very detailed error message telling you and the admin what they need to do to fix it. But it's just like, could they not have done this? To do every single user modified 17 accounts. Oh, actually. Oh well. So in a video I'll be posting soon, it was my story time regarding a road rage incident, and they can't do anything to the person because I don't have a video or picture evidence of him showing me his holster or him threatening to hurt me and kill me by shooting me and beating my ass. So I don't have any of that, and then I don't have the witnesses' information either, and that really sucked because I took a photo, but in the photo you can't distinguish the vehicle's license plates. I should have just took a video, especially of the witnesses' license plate. I'm very disappointed that I didn't do that. So it is what it is, but with this, the police department has a, what is it called? A victim service team. So they provide counseling that's free for you. And I highly recommend counseling. And I guess the reason I haven't gone in the past is because my mother wanted to pay for it, and my mother's the one that caused a lot of my issues. So I still should have done it, I just didn't want to. But now it's kind of just available to me. And also, what happened was, maybe to other people, traumatic, but when he threatened to beat me because I was a white bitch, I said, I don't care. And he kind of looked flabbergasted when I said I didn't care. But I don't know if, I'm actually really proud of myself. If anything, I wish I would have antagonized the perp more. To have more evidence to use against him, at least like to say that he hit my car, or broke my window, or hit me, you know. Just really sad that nothing can be done, and because I live in Texas, one of the most stupidest fucking states ever, they have a new law or bill, whatever, that got in place this past September, that anyone can now own a firearm, and they do not need it to be licensed or notarized or anything like that. And like, my question is, what if they did point the barrel of the gun at me and not just flashing the holster? Would it still not happen and nothing be done because there was no witness and I didn't have a video of it? Like, that really, I know it's he said, she said, but it's still just really messed up. And that also happens with stalking victims where they have to actually get hurt, or it has to get really escalated for the cops to do anything. And it's just really sad what this world is and the fear of men. It just sucks. And not all men are creepy, but most of y'all are fucking weird. And like, I just don't like talking to anyone, so that's why I like videoing, because I can talk to myself. That's all I need, you know, is myself. So having like all these other people is just weird, because I don't want any friends. And then my thought is too, is why don't I just make all of my videos private? And I have half of my videos as privated and unlisted, because I'm not taking the videos and talking about this for anyone else. And I've always said in my videos, I get scared of people judging me by what I say, what I post. I am a hypocrite. I contradict myself. I think everyone does, you know? And I just don't want people to look at me and watch me. And that's why I'd prefer this channel to stay small. Right now, I think we're right under 500. And I feel like going over 500 is gonna be a little scary. Some of my videos have over 1,000 or 10,000 views, I think, now. And at first that gave me really bad anxiety, and it's still in the back of my mind does, because society is very judgmental when it comes to women and their bodies and women and their careers. It's not like you can't do both, you know? And I'm hoping that the world just gets a lot more open, but I do have a fear of people knowing me and judging me based on what I say and post, because some stuff I wonder why I post it. I don't know. If anything, I feel like it's the log of my life. Like, I don't like writing. Like, I'll write sometimes, but I hate the act of writing. And I don't know, I feel like if I die, these will still live on and people will know it was not just a face that you remember, it's the actual person with a brain, a mouth, word, soul, you know? So, maybe it is my legacy without me wanting it to be, but I don't know. We'll go back to work now. have a meeting in less than 45 minutes. So if this doesn't die or end before then, I'll see you later. This video is... I would like to show my surroundings because it's a lot more relaxing seeing what I'm seeing. But I just get really creeped out by people knowing where I stay, wanting to find me. I just prefer to be off the radar. That's my end goal in life, is just to be off the radar, where no one can find me, and like no one can talk to me, and I can just be alone. That is my end goal. And a lot of people say that's really weird, but I think it's just pathetic when people settle with others just because they love them and they want to reproduce and have kids. It's just like, you're sick. You're sick. I'm so glad I have Dixie with me. Thank you. I just don't know what to do with my hair right now. I think trees are beautiful. Like, it's unreal. I wish I could paint. Technically, anyone can. But my patience and my perfectionism is just awful. And I know I need to get better at being a perfectionist, but it's just very hard. It's so nice working out here. I need to charge my Mac. That's so crazy seeing squirrels fight. Running around up in the trees. I always get March and May confused. Love it. I'll be going to that concert. What I need to start doing this month, since it's already March. I get March and May mixed up for some reason. Why should be last May? Last. But I guess squirrels just fight all day. Oh, okay. I remembered what I was gonna say. So, this month I need to get back into riding my motorcycle. Because my dad is trying to give me his Harley, but I'm not gonna take it if I don't ride, or I'm scared to ride it, you know? Because mine, I posted a video about my bike. It's an RPS Magician 250cc, and after my procedure, and even before my procedure, I didn't ride it. I didn't ride it for like 6 months. And then right before my procedure, I went to go ride and got really, really disappointed in myself because I kept stalling. But I didn't realize I'm stalling because I'm all the way in the fourth gear at a stoplight, you know? So it's just the things you forget when you take such a hiatus from practicing anything. And it's just really scared to not be comfortable when on the road. So scared. Sorry, these damn squirrels are distracting me. They're like going crazy. I feel like Dixie's looking at them too sometimes, but she is blind and deaf. And my dad's old bike, I believe, was 1200cc. Or 1000cc. A lot more than mine, my 250. So, and my bike that I have, my Magician, it's probably 200 pounds, maybe more, 200 to 300. And his bike, oh my gosh, his bike is probably in the 300 to 500s. And so that's like a whole different ball game. But at the same time, my current bike, I can't put both feet on the ground at the same time. I can put one foot down and have like the other one lifted up, but I've never been able to put both of my feet on the ground. And that is the scariest part. Good girl. Again. And then I'll give her a treat when she comes back. Get him, Dixie. Get him. They're running around. I was like so surprised she hadn't started barking and being her cute self. Dixie, you a treat? No, ma'am. Come here. Hey, come here. Come. No. Come here. Come. Good girl. Give me kisses. No. No, no, no. Come. Dixie Day. Dixie. Come here. I know you can hear me. Come here. This way. Give me kisses. Nope. Give me kisses. Nope. kisses. Yes. You bet. Good dog. And then Shiny start riding my bike again so I could ride my dad's and have my dad's, because he's offered to give it to me, but he's not gonna give it to me if I don't ride it, you know, and feel comfortable riding it. So the next thing I need to practice and do is skating, like rollerblading skating. I also purchased Heelys. That is on my channel as well. You can see me fail with my Heelys, but I just have some things I need to do, and I need to stop being lazy, because sleep is my favorite thing in the world. Like, my bed is so comfortable, you don't want to leave it. Sorry, she's just like chewing in the background. Let's listen to her ASMR. Let's not interrupt. Got a few pieces left. Look. 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 Hey, look. Look. See what happens when you come and you be a good girl? See what happens when you come when I call you? I've recorded a bunch of videos to post. It's March 3rd, so I don't know what order you'll be seeing them. I had a crazy night a couple of weeks ago and ended up losing my purse with my card and my driver's license, and with that I had to freeze my account and my application I use to merge my videos and edit them is currently ended for my subscription since it failed to go through. So, oopsie-daisy. So I'll post this one since there were no cuts and just an easy post. So hopefully you'll be seeing everything else here shortly. But that's all from my channel. I guess I'll just end it now, say my goodbyes, and Hope you all have a good rest of the day. Trans rights are equal rights. I identify as she, her, they, them. This is Trisha Paytas' band, Sad Boy 2005, They, Them, and this is the collab with Marsan Brands. So I hope y'all have a good rest of the day. I'm gonna be chilling here with Dixie working, and I'll be going back to the office tomorrow. So it'll be different. So, all right. Thanks for watching. I think I want to do a thing now, since unfortunately the channel is getting a little bigger and there are people actually watching my things, is if you can put a comment down and, I don't know, tell me like a funny yo mama joke, a good pickup line, a cheesy pickup line, or like a terrible dad joke, something along those lines. If you post anything inappropriate or just mad weird, it will get removed because we like to be comfortable in our own spaces, you know. So thanks for watching. I will talk to y'all later. Have a good day, and with the world that's happening right now in Ukraine, it's really sad. Don't know what's going to happen. Hopefully nothing too crazy, but what can you expect when it's men as the leaders in places where they're still not allowing people to be equal? So of course there's going to be turmoil, you know? There always will be. That will never change. People will always be shitty. Tomorrow will be worse. So, and that's a quote from Bailey Draws on Instagram. Look him up, highly recommend his art, plan on getting it one day, but his quote is, tomorrow will be worse. But thanks for watching. Have a good night, uglies. Talk to you later. And oh, so when you do put the comment, I'll shout you out in my favorite one in the next video. So I'll have to remember that one. So bye, uglies.